Water, water everywhere on all the moons of freeze. Water, water everywhere, please, alien life, say cheese. Sup, planetoids, thanks for watching DNews. Y'all know me, I'm Trace. We often hear we know more about space than we do about the depths of our own oceans. Whether that's true or not, and it's arguable, what about the oceans on other planets? What do we know about them? Firstly, Earth is the only planet anywhere in the universe that we know has stable liquid water on its surface. There are other celestial bodies we suspect of having oceans, though, like Europa and Ganymede, moons of Jupiter, and Enceladus, a moon of Saturn. It's just the oceans are trapped under sheets of ice. In fact, a new study in Geophysical Research Letters from mid-2016 says tiny Enceladus may have a rocky core, internal ocean, and that ice shell. Using data from the Cassini probe and 7 years of observations, scientists believe under a max 22-kilometer thick icy shell sits a salty water ocean. Another paper says it might be 70 kilometers, it's a debate. They discovered this by looking at the wobble of the moon as it orbits Saturn. As the moon zooms around the planet, the scientists realized the moon's wobble, called a libration, appeared to move in such a way that it could only be explained if the icy surface wasn't connected to the moon's core. It's almost as if the moon is sloshing like a milk jug or a bowl of water. That is so cool. Though not so cool that the ocean inside is frozen through, though, which is weird. Out of the southern hemisphere of the moon, scientists spotted over 100 warm geysers. So they flew Cassini through the jets to sample the mist. It's super salty water. Here on Earth, the only model we have to go by, life in the open ocean is rare. So we don't yet know if there's life under those icy sheets. We'll have to design another probe to scoop up the geyser mists without smashing any possible life that exists inside. But even with Enceladus's ocean, Europa is far more intriguing. Europa is slightly smaller than our moon, but larger than Pluto, and NASA believes Europa has, like Earth, an iron core, a rocky mantle, and a rocky surface. And on top of that rocky surface is an ocean of salty water. Unlike Earth, but like Enceladus, Europa also has this frozen, icy crust and may have salty water jets. The reason Europa is more intriguing than Enceladus? Life needs three things: energy, water, and heat. In another study in Geophysical Research Letters, scientists from NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory think judging by Europa's neighbor Io, volcanic activity may exist inside the icy crust of the moon. If so, it may mean both heat and nutrients exist where the rocky crust meets the water, and there might be what's called a redox reaction, or reduction in oxidation, a chemical process that's similar to what we have here on Earth. And if this holds true, then the volcanic activity brings heat and minerals, and of course, there's water. So life, mofo, do you speak it? Europa just might. Look, it's actually easier to launch a probe to a moon in the outer solar system or point telescopes like the Hubble at a tiny moon than it is to brave the depths of our own oceans. It seems to me the more we learn about these other moons and exoplanets, the more likely we're going to understand oceans in general, and hopefully we can infer more about our own ocean in the process. You might be wondering what the difference is between a moon and a planet, right? Is there one? Amy has the breakdown for you in this video here. Would you visit a moon? Which one? Ours? Europa? Phobos? What's your fave? Let us know in the comments. Please subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.